guys, I'm Vipri Deshi and today's video is going to be on eyeshadow palettes available in India. And all these palettes are for less than 2000 rupees. Most of these are palettes that I really like, but there are a few things that I wish was not there or the price point could have been better or something like that. So I will talk about this as and when I talk about the eyeshadow palettes. All these palettes are easily available in India. You can get it on Myntra, you can get it on Amazon, you can get it on Nykaa, you can get it on hopemakeup.com. So I will tell you guys where I got it from and for how much and stuff like that. So I'm going to be talking about these palettes in no particular order. So the first one I'm going to be talking about is the Makeup Revolution, now called Revolution Beauty Sofix Eyeshadow Palette. This is in collaboration with a YouTuber. Now I think she did an amazing job in picking out these shades. It's amazing, like the shades are so put together. There's not one thing that you'd be missing. There's like a dark matte black which you can use for your liner if you want to add some depth to your eye look. There are like nice colors as well. All these shades are something that work very well with each other, or if you have any other eyeshadow palette, I think it would work hand in hand with that. It has a very nice mirror as well. So this I feel is like an amazing eyeshadow palette. Now I got this one from Revolution Beauty website for about 800 rupees or something like that. Now don't get disheartened if you've paid more here, because I did pay duty for this and there was a shade that was completely shattered. My package was actually completely shattered. So I would recommend getting it from India itself. Any website that sells authentic Makeup Revolution products, you can get it from there. So I feel like this is a very good palette. The matte shades blend beautifully. It doesn't skip, or there's no kind of like, you know, patchiness on your eye when you blend it. It works really well, very smooth. And I feel like the formula of this eyeshadow palette is way more different compared to all the other eyeshadow palettes from Makeup Revolution. So they've done a really good job in the formula of these. And the shimmer shades are very pigmented. They are very like creamy and buttery on the eye. Most of this is really nice, except few shades that do crumble off, like the typical Makeup Revolution eyeshadows. Like this shade does look a little bit crumbly on the eye, but it is a very beautiful shade, and all of these shades are really nice, work really well, and I feel like it works for any skin tone. Sometimes eyeshadow palettes don't work for like medium or medium tan and deep skin tones. Like the Urban Decay Naked palette doesn't work for my skin tone is what I feel. Like it doesn't pack a punch. But if you are of a lighter skin tone, it shows up a lot better on your eyelid. But these shades show up irrespective of your skin tone, and it's a really good palette. It has a nice mirror. It's something you can travel with, and I wouldn't say it's completely worth the price you get it, because it's really expensive in India. But I've seen the price of this come down to about 1400 something, and I think it's worth that price, because even if you get it from the Revolution Beauty website, you end up paying duty, and most of the times your eyeshadow palette is shattered. So at least from India, you know that you don't have to pay duty and stuff like that. So get it on a sale and I don't think you'll be disappointed. It's a really good palette, and even if you are a beginner, I think you would really like this palette. The next palette I'm going to be talking about is also one of my favorite from Makeup Revolution. This is the iHeart Makeup Chocolate Wise palette. Now I do have quite a few Makeup Revolution products in this. That's because they make good quality affordable eyeshadow palettes, and that's the reason I've included a lot of that. Now, and from the looks of this, you can make out that I've used this a ton. This is a palette that I reach out for a lot when I want my eye look to be simple but quick, and I don't want to think too much, because all these shades are so cohesive. They look so bland, but they work really well together. So you can't get like crazy dramatic looks out of this, but the look you can get out of this is really nice. So if you're someone who is just starting out and you're looking for a very basic neutral eyeshadow palette, I think you can go for this and you won't be disappointed. Again, I think the shades in this work really well for like medium and medium tan skin tones as well, so you don't have to worry about shades not showing up on your skin tone. The mattes are really pigmented. I like this dark brown that they have in this, which really packs a punch when you use it in the outer corner. These shades are beautiful as transition shades. They blend beautifully. Some of this has like a little bit of satin finish to it, so again it looks really nice on the eye. And the shimmer shades again is that typical like crumbly shimmer shade, but looks really nice, super pigmented. And I wouldn't recommend wetting these shimmer shades, because then it looks a little too messy on the eye. But other than that, this is a really really nice eyeshadow palette. I have reviewed this shade by shade in another video, you can check that out as well. And this retails for about 1450 on Nykaa, and it goes down to about 1080 rupees or something like that, and I feel like it's worth the price if you want to get it. And I feel like on Amazon sometimes you can get it for a much lesser price, so just look out for the right kind of deals and buy this. And it's like a very nice palette to have. So the next eyeshadow palette I'm going to be talking about is from NYX. This is their NYX Ultimate Shadow Palette, and this one is in the variant Warm Neutrals. There is a cool tone palette in the same thing, and there are different like bright colored ones, and also they have released the multi finish version, which was down to 1100 rupees when there was like flat 30% off on NYX recently on Nykaa. But because I have quite a few eyeshadow palettes, I didn't go ahead and pick it up. If you guys really like NYX eyeshadows, you can definitely give that a try as well. And this one I feel like is a perfect dupe for the Morphe 35O eyeshadow palette. Like if you wanted to buy that but you couldn't get your hands on it, this is a compact version of that, and this is a perfect travel palette in my opinion. It has these very pigmented dark warm eyeshadows which are matte in finish, and they work really well on the eyelids. They blend beautifully and they look really nice. The shimmer shades in this eyeshadow doesn't pack that much of a punch. Like it's not very pigmented like the Makeup Revolution one, but I wouldn't say that it completely disappears and vanishes on your eye. There's nothing that a little bit of fixing spray can't fix, so you can of course make it work with that. There are 9 matte shades and 7 shimmer shades in this, and it's again like that perfect blend of eyeshadows. They go hand in hand, and again, pick this up only when there's a sale on NYX, like on Nykaa for flat 30% off or something. Then I think you wouldn't regret buying this. Don't pay the full price for this. Like I didn't pay full price for this as well, and I don't really regret buying this. So I do really like this palette. The next palette I'm going to be talking about is the PAC Ultimate Shadow Box Luxe Collection. Now this is in the Morphe variant. Now I've also compared this eyeshadow to the Huda Beauty Morphe Obsessions palette, like if it's a dupe or not in another video. Do check that out. I will link it down in the description box below, and I think you would be really interested to see that video because you can see that the color scheme is like pretty much the same, and it's like they've tried to dupe it shade to shade. And this, I was pleasantly surprised with the pigmentation of these eyeshadows. I didn't expect it to be this pigmented. They work really well on the eyes. They blend beautifully, and the shimmer shades again pack a punch. You don't have to work too hard. I mean, you just get only 9 eyeshadows and you have to pay 1650 including shipping from Amazon, but the original retail price of this is 1500. I think it's like you're paying about 140 rupees or something like that for each eyeshadow. It might seem a little too much, but I think it's completely worth it because these eyeshadows are very pigmented. They work beautifully, again, hand in hand. If you don't like this kind of a color scheme, you can of course go with their warm variant. They have another smoky variant, exactly duping the Huda Beauty eyeshadow. So if you're not willing to spend 2500 rupees on Huda Beauty eyeshadow palettes, you can try this one. The next one I'm going to be talking about is the Makeup Revolution Fortune Favors the Brave eyeshadow palette. Again, this is in collaboration with some British beauty blogger or something like that. This is a very, very raved about eyeshadow palette. A lot of people talk about this. A lot of people really enjoy this palette back in the day. My mirror is completely shattered. I'm trying to not make any crazy movements and shatter the mirror. So this is what happens when you order it from the Revolution Beauty website. There's always going to be like some issue with your palettes. But anyways, let's move on to these eyeshadows now. I don't know if you guys can see how small the eyeshadow pan is. It looks a lot bigger when you like look at the pictures and stuff like that, but this is like a really tiny eyeshadow pan, and there are a lot of shades. Now if you get it from the Revolution Beauty website, it's for I think 900 or 800 rupees, which I think is worth the price. But in India, you get it for about 1900, which is really, really steep for this palette. I'll tell you why. There's no problem with the pigmentation and the shimmer shades and stuff like that, but some of these shades, like especially these matte shades, it's dark green and dark blue shade, look like they're very pigmented, but they go on a little bit patchy on the eye, and your eye look will not look blended no matter how much of blending that you do. But the shimmer shades are really pretty. You can't compare this to the other Makeup Revolution palettes like the Sofix palette or even the Chocolate Vice palette, and those are, I feel like, much affordable compared to this and much better quality. But I wouldn't completely reject this and say that this is a very bad palette. I've seen a lot of people rave about this. A lot of people in India still do buy this, and a lot of people ask me if I like this palette. So this is my opinion. It's like a mixed opinion. Like I don't completely hate it, but I don't really love it. So it's up to you guys what you go and spend your money on. Next eyeshadow palette I'm going to be talking about is also from Makeup Revolution. This is NYHEART Makeup Chocolate Rose Gold palette. Now I did a comparison of this palette with the Chocolate Vice palette, and you guys know my opinion on this. I feel like if you have the Chocolate Vice palette, then go ahead and invest in this palette, because I feel like the shades are not very well put together in this. Like there's only so many eye looks that you can do, and sometimes it doesn't look put together. And it's a beautiful color scheme. I just find myself reaching for other eyeshadow palettes palettes as well, like just to mix up my shades when I'm using this palette. But I wouldn't complain about the quality or anything of that sort. It's similar to the Chocolate Vice palette, like the mattes blend beautifully, the shimmer shades are pigmented. I just find that there are some shades missing in this, like there's no dark brown shade that I can use in my outer corner or even a black. But other than that, all these shades are so pretty and they really work for, again, any skin tone. And this is a very, very beautiful eyeshadow palette. So if you have quite a few eyeshadow palettes in your collection, then you can go ahead and invest this. But if you're a beginner and you're going to just start out with one eyeshadow palette, I wouldn't recommend going with this one, because again, you'll get lost in figuring out what kind of eye look that you want to go with. So the next eyeshadow palette I'm going to be talking about is from LA Colors. This is their Sweet 16 color eyeshadow palette. This one is in the variant Brave. They have quite a few color options again. Now, as you guys can see, I have like somewhat similar pattern of eyeshadow. Like this one looks quite similar to the Chocolate Vice palette. As you guys can see, like there's like a similar color theme that I have, but these are just the eyeshadows that I use regularly. I don't go for anything that's too cool toned. So if you're looking for a cool toned eyeshadow palette, you'll be completely disappointed with this video. So that's not something that I go for. So you guys can see there is like a certain pattern that I stick to, and those are the kind of eyeshadows that I like to use because it works well with my skin tone. I don't really like very cool toned looks on my eyes, and I feel like it doesn't flatter my skin tone very well, and so that's the reason I'm sticking to this. So of course, if you have any cool toned eyeshadow palettes that you really love, you can recommend it in the comment section down below, and I think a lot of people would benefit out of it. Now this one is a very affordable eyeshadow palette. You can get it for about 540 rupees on sale, and the original retail price of this is 675 rupees. Again, not very expensive, less than 1,000 rupees. A very, very good eyeshadow palette. The matte shades are beautiful. There are majority of matte shades in this with just few shimmer shades. Now again, the shimmer shades are similar to the NYX eyeshadow palette, but doesn't mean that there's no color payoff at all. You have to wet your brush and bring out the pigment, work a little bit, but again, won't pack a punch like the Makeup Revolution eyeshadow palettes. But I think for the price, you really can't complain about it. You get 16 eyeshadows, which is really good. And when you're starting out, you can of course work with this, play with this, really nice shades. Like this pigmented matte brown shade is there, and there are like really nice transition shades that go really well with Indian skin tone. I personally prefer like warmer shades in my crease and warmer shades to use as my transition shades, rather than using something really muddy and cool tone. I wouldn't say like it's the best, but for the price, you really can't complain. And with the lack of eyeshadow palettes in India, I think this is a good option to try out. Now, another one that is very, very similar in color scheme is the Wet n Wild Color Icon eyeshadow palette in the shade Rosé in the Air. Now, if you look at these two eyeshadows side by side, they look very, very similar. There are a lot of similar shades in this, so it's like a dupe of each other. So out of these two, which one would I recommend? I would still say go with the LA Colors one, because you get 16 eyeshadows in this, and in this you get 10 eyeshadows. So again, you get more eyeshadows in that. And the reason I'm recommending that over this is because, again, these shimmer shades are not very pigmented, but the matte shades are beautiful. So you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You get 8 matte shades and just 2 shimmer shades, so there's not much of an option left for you guys. And also, I got this one from Nykaa, but I know that Hoke Makeup is the one who actually distributes and retails Wet n Wild products. So if you've got anything from this batch, there's a mold on this eyeshadow, which that's the reason I can't use this shade at all. I don't want to use that on my eyes and create some kind of allergy, which I'm very disappointed with, because I think you have to monitor the quality of products you want to sell to your customers. You can't send something with a mold on it. And when you're going to sell something to your customers, you can't sell something with such poor quality. Like, you have to go through quality check and sell it. Like, be it Hoke Makeup or even Nykaa or Myntra, whoever it is, you can't just try to push your stock to your customers. You know, you have to care about the quality that you're giving them for the money. I'm scared if that's going to start growing onto the other eyeshadows as well. And I put this one up on my Instagram story, and a lot of people mentioned that they've faced the same issue. Like, I think it's a batch issue. This one particular batch of eyeshadows have mold in it. Anyways, that aside, the matte eyeshadows are really pigmented, and you get like this really big transition shade, a warm brown. But this cool tone brown is something that I'm never going to be using. Can you guys see that? That's like gray, so it would look really muddy on my eyes, and that's something that I don't like using on my eyelids at all. So I would probably just stick to these eyeshadows. But would I say it's completely worth the money? Maybe it is, because it retails for only 499 rupees. You can get it for 360 rupees on Hook Makeup and even on Myntra and even on Nykaa sometimes. So on a sale, it's actually not even that expensive. But so it's about your interest. You can mix and match anything and jazz up any eyeshadow palette. Also, I have this old Comfort Zone eyeshadow palette from Wet n Wild that I got a while back, and I saw that this was recently launched even on Hook Makeup, and it's on sale currently for 250 rupees. And I think this is a very, very good eyeshadow palette for 250 rupees. I don't think it's a big burden on anybody to go ahead and try this one out. It doesn't lack matte eyeshadows, so this is not the only eyeshadow palette that you can keep and work with. But if you have other eyeshadow palettes and you want like this beautiful duochrome shade, which is available in the current Comfort Zone palette as well, if you don't have that and if you don't want to spend like say 360 or 499 rupees, you can go ahead and try this, because this is for 250 rupees and it's very affordable, and it has these beautiful shimmer shades. All the shimmer shades in this are beautiful. I've always enjoyed using this and I still do use it, and because I have this, that is one of the reasons why I have actually not gone ahead and bought the new Comfort Zone palette. But if you have that, don't go and buy this, okay? Like, it's almost like buying the same thing. So the next eyeshadow palette I'm going to be talking about is from Freedom Makeup. I think this one is currently discontinued by Revolution Beauty. I don't think you can find this on their site anymore. I think you can still find this on Nykaa or Amazon. Now, the reason that I like this palette is because, one, I got this for about 200 rupees on the Revolution Beauty website, and that's the reason I find this to be like worth the money. But don't pay 1200, 1300 or something like that for this. This is not worth it. If it's anywhere like 500 or 600, again, you can go ahead and pay that much money for this, because you want something that is really colorful, say in your lower lash line, or you want to create a colorful eyeshadow look, and then this comes into play and it works really well. It has like the super pigmented bright neon pink shade, a neon yellow shade. This one can be a little bit patchy on the eye, but this pink works really well, and all these colorful shimmer shades. So it just has two matte shades and the rest are shimmer, and all these colorful shimmer shades work really well on the eye. I have used this as well, and more or less I use all of this on the lower lash line more than using it on my lid as such. I think you can find this for a really affordable price on Amazon. I will try to find the links and stuff like that and notify you guys when it goes on a good sale. I feel like it's good to have a colorful palette in hand. If you do have any other eyeshadow palette, do let me know. This is like a good companion palette for your other eyeshadow palettes. So that in that way, this is a pretty good palette. So the next eyeshadow palette I'm going to be talking about is the Maybelline City Mini palette. This one is in the shade Rooftop Bronzes. Now this comes in different variants, and I actually wanted to get the Urban Jungle one because it has few greens and stuff like that. But this again is a good quality eyeshadow palette. But look at the size of this. This is really tiny, so pick it up only on sale. Now this one retails for 750 rupees, which is completely not worth the price at all. If you can get it for a flat 30% off, then it's worth your money. So this has again only shimmer shades, but you have to have other matte eyeshadows to work with this. I've created a nice look with a mixture of all of these shades, and I really liked how the look turned out. You can intensify it with some makeup fixing spray, and it is a really good eyeshadow palette. But would I say like go ahead and buy only this? No. This is just like an again companion palette, because the shimmer shades are really nice and they work really well on the eyes as well. So the last palette I'm going to be talking about, and I'm currently out of breath and super thirsty as well. So the last eyeshadow palette I'm going to be talking about is the Revolution Reloaded Neutrals 2 eyeshadow palette. Now this one again comes with different color options. Now this is again a very good eyeshadow palette. Very, very pigmented, like very pigmented matte shades. Look at that. It's beautiful. I also have a mixture of these shades on my eye today. Like, I've used so many eyeshadow palettes today, I don't even have a count. And I've used a mixture of this and this in my outer V, and then I use this one in the inner part just to cut the crease a little bit. This is a very pretty eyeshadow palette. Again, a companion eyeshadow palette. Do not go ahead and buy only this and expect everything out of this palette, because it doesn't have that very pigmented matte brown shade. It doesn't have like a lot of different shimmer shades, and these are all like similar, like orange toned color family and little bit of pinks here. So this is a good palette, but if you have like the other Reloaded palettes, I think you would like that over this. But this is again very good in terms of quality. These don't like perform poorly or anything of that sort. So if you have like say the chocolate white palette and you wanted something a little bit more brighter, you can use this. Try out the other variants that they have in this and let me know how you like it, because I'm not going to be buying that anytime soon and I'm really curious to know if you guys like that. So do let me know what are your favorite eyeshadow palettes that is available in the Indian market that is pretty affordable as well. I think it will help a lot of people, and I hope you found this video helpful as well. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.